So far in this course, all the tables which we were looking were from mill standard 105, which is equivalent to Z1.4, NCASQ standard Z1.4. So this is something which we have been seeing so far, which is here. Now we are looking at another set of tables, which is Dodge roaming tables. This is different from Z1.4. If you remember, in Z1.4 tables, our emphasis was on AQL. We were looking at 1.5% AQL, acceptable quality limit. And based on that, we were deciding what is the acceptance number and what is the rejection number. So AQL was the basis there. Whereas in Dodge roaming tables, there are two sets of tables. One set of table based on LQL or LTPD or RQL. These are all the same thing, which we have used earlier as RQL, as rejectable quality limit. We have talked about that in the basics when we were studying LTPD, lot tolerance percent defective. And here this is a new term, but this also means the same thing, which is LQL or limiting quality level. These three things are same. So there is one set of table which is based on this, and there is a second set of table which is based on AOQL. AOQL is average outgoing quality limit. And we have learned about this in theory part as well, where we have calculated average outgoing quality, which was AOQ, and the curve of that came something like this. And we said the top of this, the maximum of this, of AOQ is AOQL, average outgoing quality limit. So this is on the average, this is the quality level which the receiver will receive. So there is a second set of table based on AOQL. Let's look at few other differences between these two. So mill standard or Z1.4 has single sampling, double sampling and multiple sampling, whereas in Dodge roaming, you don't have multiple sampling. You either have single or double sampling. We will focus on single sampling only in quick examples, which we will look after this difference. The emphasis of Z1.4 or mill standard is to protect the producer. This is more in favor of producer, whereas Dodge roaming tables are more in favor of the customer. Because if you look at these AOQL, so what's the average outgoing quality limit? This protects the consumer that on the average, you will be receiving this level of quality. LQL is the limiting quality level. This is the worst type of quality which you could receive in exceptional cases. So the Dodge roaming tables protect the customer. Intent here is to minimize the ATI. ATI is average total inspection, and we have talked about this as well in theory, that on the average, how many inspections we do. So if we have poor quality lot, then more and more of these lots will get rejected, and these rejected lots need to go through 100% screening. That will lead to more number of inspections being done. And based on that, we earlier found out what is the ATI in each of these cases of product quality. So when we have a 1% defective lot, how many items on the average we inspect? So if we have a lot which has 2% defective, then what is ATI? And we plotted a curve for that as well. And we understood that if the lot quality goes bad, then we need to do more and more inspections. At the end, we more or less end up with 100% inspection. So here the intent of Dodge roaming table is to minimize the ATI. Here in these tables, you need process average. You need the estimate of the process average, that on the average, how much rejections your process is producing. 1%, 1.5% or so on. You need this number to look at the table. And where do you get this value is, you look at the past history. And based on that, the recent data, you estimate the value of the process average. And just in case, if you have got no process average, if you don't know anything about that process, in that case, you use the largest value in the table. So in that case, you look at process average, which is the worst process average in the table. So with this basic understanding, now let's look at these two tables, one based on LQL and the second based on AOQL. So here is the first table, which is based on LQL, and which you can see here, this table is based on LQL. But the first thing which you need here is to look at the process average. What is the level of rejections on the average your process is producing? And this you can find based on the past history. If nothing is available, go for this one, which is the worst one. Let's take an example where we need AOQL of 3%. So this is the curve which we plotted for AOQ in case of mill standard 105. This I'm showing for reference. And this was your AOQL. AOQL was something in this case 2.4% roughly. So this is something which you want to define beforehand, that I want AOQL of 3% and the lot which I receive is having 1000 pieces. My process average is known here, which is 1.5%. That is good. So I can use this particular column. So this is the column I am looking at. Now, since my lot size is 1000, so I look at this row here, which is 1000. So that's my row. And this leads me to this area. And this tells me that in this particular scenario, I need to pick 44 pieces. Small n is equal to 44 and C is equal to 2. C is the acceptance number. Earlier also, I said there are two ways to show that. One way is to show that AC and RE, acceptable and rejectable. Second one is to show as C and R. C for acceptance number, R for rejection number. So anything which is equal to or less than this, you accept that. So in this particular case, when you pick 44 items, so if you get 2 or less number of defectives, then you accept this lot. Otherwise, you reject this lot. And in this particular case, you will end up with LQL or the limiting quality level as 11.8%. And 11.8% is here in this curve, what we plotted earlier. So LQL or rejectable quality limit. Rejectable quality limit was at this level, you want to reject most of the lots. So most of the lots which have rejection rate of 11.8% will be rejected. But there is still a risk that some of these might get accepted. And that is shown by beta. So this is how you look at this table when you have a defined AOQL. And what is the second table here? Let's look at that as well. Here in the second table, you define LTPD or RQL, rejectable quality limit. In the previous example, this RQL came out to be around 11%. Here we are defining that we want RQL to be 3%. If you want RQL to be 3%, lot size of 1000 items, process average of 1.5%. So you look at this table, which is 1.5%. And here, if you look at lot size of 1000, which is here, which leads you to this area. Now here, if you see, now earlier we were talking about around 40 samples to be picked. Here we are asking about picking 290 pieces, 290 samples, because you wanted this RQL to be 3%. Earlier when we picked around 40 items, this came out to be 11%. But if you want this to be 3%, then you need to pick 290 items. And in 290 items, if you get 5 or less rejections, then you accept the lot. Otherwise, you reject the lot. And with this, you will end up with AOQL of 0.78. This in the previous example was 3%. The previous example, we took this as the basis and we found out RQL. Here we took RQL as the basis and we found out AOQL. So this is how these two tables work out in case of Dodge Roaming Plan.